As we've been reporting all morning long, FBI has now joined that search. They joined the Maine State Police, also the Waterville Police Department. They're looking for the missing toddler. 20-month-old Ayla Reynolds has not been seen since she was put to bed Friday night. Now, we rejoin News 8's Dave Guthro. He's been live in Waterville all morning long, and he's got the latest information, including a search, Dave, that's going to get underway fairly soon, you told us.
Well, thanks, Shannon. That's right. It has been a busy morning here in Waterville already. We're at Waterville Police Department. Over an hour ago, state police officials and Maine Warden Service officials began arriving here. And as we showed you just behind me, about 10 minutes ago, the Mobile Command Center for the state police arrived here at the Waterville Police Department as the investigation continues into the disappearance of 20-month-old Ayla Reynolds, who's been missing since early Saturday morning. Police saying that the toddler was last seen in her bed on Friday night. Now, in a news conference yesterday afternoon, police say they have spoken with Ayla's family. That includes her mother, Trista Reynolds, who lives in Portland but does not have a permanent address there. Ayla actually lived in Portland with her mother and grandmother until mid-October. Now, the family has been cooperating fully to this point. Waterville Police Chief Joseph Massey has called in the state police, as you see, the Maine Warden Service, as well as the FBI to assist in this case. Chief Massey says an Amber Alert wasn't issued because this case didn't meet the requirements. Amber Alert requires both the suspect and a vehicle, two things police didn't have. They continue to urge the public to contact police with any information about Ayla's whereabouts. And in the meantime, to help police find the missing girl, locals in the Waterville area have organized their own search groups.
Help facilitate that if anybody out there knows anything, and I suspect that probably someone out there may know where the little girl is, is to please call us. Please call the Waterville Police Department at 680-4700. We need your help. I think time is of its essence. We'd like to get her back home.
I just hope she's safe. I hope she's warm. I hope she's fed. And I hope she's not hurt. And I hope we do find her alive.
Well, again, Ayla was reported missing on Saturday morning by her father, Justin DiPietro, from their house on Violet Avenue. That's about a mile and a half from where we are at the Waterville Police Department. Again, she is 20 months old, 2 feet 9 inches tall, weighs around 30 pounds. She has short, thin blonde hair, and her left arm is in a sling and soft splint. Ayla actually broke her arm in an accidental fall 3 weeks ago. She was last seen wearing green one-piece pajamas with white polka dots and the words "Daddy's Princess" written on them. And the troopers we've spoken to this morning here say that the search will continue this morning. The command center is here now so they can begin getting that search underway in earnest. They also just told me a couple of minutes ago that the police chief does expect to meet with the media at some point this afternoon. Right now, they say around 2 o'clock to deliver any information they are able to come up with this morning. They have not ruled anything out. An abduction is being considered at this point, as well as a number of other things. And again, they have spoken to everyone that was at the house on Friday evening, including non-family members, and the investigation is ongoing. We're going to have the latest developments throughout the day on our website, WMTW.com, and of course, a full recap tonight on News 8 at 6. Live in Waterville, I'm Dave Guthro, News 8.